I have a lazy eye. Actually, I call it my easy bake eye. I got a bad case of easy bake eye. Don't feel bad. I think there's a reason. You know, there's always a reason. I have prayed to God, why do I have a lazy eye? You know, and I think it's so I don't know when I'm around shallow people. I don't know if that's it or I get to park my sound. Just, I'm there. Get out. Tell me if you think this would be funny. If I prayed to God to fix my lazy eye and God said, I don't know, are you talking to me or... Is that a keeper? God, I have to pray like this. if you have a lazy eye, you know, it is. People actually will move over when I'm talking to them. But it does make you kind of funny. So that's the silver lining. Actually, I say every cloud has a silly lining. I'm writing a book about like kind of tragic, funny stories just to demonstrate that. I go around talking about humor and why we actually need it. I don't know if a lot of people know this. It's a basic human need. I actually have a history as a registered nurse. And thank you, one person. No, you don't have to clap for that. But yes, are you a nurse also? With a wiener dog. What are the odds? What are the odds? We are maybe, you know, what did we get disconnected at birth or something? I mean, do you have a lazy eye? Yeah, I can tell. You're looking right at me. I'm actually talking to you and that guy in the hat. He's like, I'm not a nurse. Why is she saying this? My eye goes out and up slightly. Kind of like it makes the move like a chess, you know, piece. Like the knight goes up over, you know, over one. Anyway, over two, whatever. Over up one, over two, up two, over one, doesn't matter. But that's basically, okay, so you are a nurse too. I thank you for doing the job that I could not do. I actually got out of nursing for the same reason a lot of people get into it, to save lives. I'm not a great nurse. I didn't want to really be a nurse. My mom tricked me, that's another story. So that's how that works. Is your mom a nurse?
No,
because that happens. Is your dad an alcoholic? He's right there. He's like, no. That's not how that works. Sometimes you go into nursing because your mom's a nurse, your dad's an alcoholic, because it's, you know, there's something about being codependent. A lot of us, I come from 5 generations of nurses. That's a lot of codependency. If you know about codependency, we have a little trouble having our own feelings. We have other people's feelings for them. And I actually have pendants that I sometimes sell. They're called codependents. And on one side, they say, I honor myself. Because that's what we need to learn to do in life, is honor ourselves. And on the other side, if you don't mind. Again, first draft. But thank you for doing that job. My mom, she never told me to be a nurse. I would have argued. Again, it was through the gifts and toys, how we program our kids. I give my son Legos. He wants to be an engineer. My mother gave me dolls, but not the normal dolls that wet and cried. I got a doll that choked and then fainted. I don't know if you had Recessa Annie. Did she ever bring home the Recessa? Anybody else get that doll that you drag out from under the Christmas tree and try and revive before she drifts towards the little dolly white light? I'm still doing CPR from 1983, by the way. I'm not learning the new stuff. It's just too hard. Unlearning is the hardest thing we do. I'm still doing the neck tilt 5-to-1. Come on. It's good enough. You get the knockoff doll at Walmart, the Heidi Heimlich maneuver. Chicken bone sold separately. Pull our little string. Hi, my name's Heidi. Gee, this chicken is delicious. Watch out. A lot of dolls do drift towards the dolly white light, which turns out is the light from the Easy Bake Oven. Who left that on this whole time? Somebody left it on. I love being a nurse. I actually, one of my favorite jobs, I did hospice nursing, and that's actually how I ended up doing stand-up comedy, because I witnessed people going through death and dying, and I know this is not a great comedy subject, but it's a part of life, you know? And life is short, and life is beautiful, and do what you love, and that's what I learned from these people. The gift they gave me when I saw people dying with peace was that they had lived their dreams. They had honored their hearts. And I always wanted to do stand-up since I was very, very little, since I was born cross-eyed. I always wanted to, because people laughed at me. I might as well make money at it. So I just, that's the gift I got from doing hospice nursing. And I wasn't really meant to be a nurse. I mean, look at, it's all about them. Have you noticed that in nursing? Obviously, I like attention from strangers. When you're on the floor, it's like, oh, my arm is broken, my chest is hurting, my cervix is dilating, me, 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 me. And that's just the doctors. A couple of you have met the doctors.